Hello, this is a tutorial for FreeCAD to create parametric 3D models. This was inspired by a FreeCAD post I saw this morning, and I want to show how such a thing can be created parametrically. So first of all, I create a new file, and I'm in part design modus, and I only need the spreadsheet mode for the parametric table, and I need this macro here. It's called Alias Manager. This can be installed here by the add-on manager. You choose this tool, and you can start it by choosing macros, and here's Alias Manager. When you have installed it, and you can put it into first of all, I change the language of FreeCAD to English so that you can better see what I'm doing. Here it's macro, and here at tools add-on manager you can create it, and by customize you have the toolbars here, and you can add a toolbar. I have called it add-ons, and inside this I've put the Alias Manager by choosing here a macro. I have to look at macros, and there's Alias Manager. Click it, click to this arrow here, and it puts is put into this folder. Okay, that's all about the Alias Manager. First, I go into the spreadsheet mode and create a new spreadsheet. I name it AAA to be short, that sure that I can type it fast, this name. And I go back here, but no, I don't do it. I open this spreadsheet, go to this FreeCAD area, here Windows, use the function tile, and I have this here, make it small, make this bigger, and start by creating some parameter names. The piece consists of a block in the middle. It's flat, this block, and it has at the left and right, it has two wings, and I need the parameters for this. So first we have the size of this block. It has a height, it's h1, a length l1, and this. And it has a thickness T1. So H1 is, say, 50 millimeters, L1 is 50 millimeters, and this is 3 millimeters. Then we have, we can start by creating it. Now I use this function here, this Alias Manager. But I go back to the part design modus. This is the correct icon here. Click it, column B, it's correct, and this is must be put to 5 or 4. It's working with without changing the parameters. Now these get yellow, and these are now able can be used inside the calculation. Okay, close it. I delete the second spreadsheet. I've pressed something wrong, so go to where is delete, copy, cut, delete. There's delete, and now I go into the drawing area and create something. So first of all, I create a new body. I don't need to name it, I can name it piece one, whatsoever. Now I create a sketch, and this is created in the XY plane, and I draw a rectangle here. This rectangle is made symmetrically, so compress these two endpoints and the midpoint and click on this function here. It's constrained symmetrically, and now it's symmetrically whatever you do to the parameters. So I have the length, this is this parameter. I use this function here, press on this fx circle, and here I type in aaa dot l1, and now I create, I use this line here, create a new dimension, press this fx little thing there, and aaa dot h1. I change, I close this, see it here, and now I change the height to say 35, and the drawing is changed. Now I want to make it thick, so I use the function, it's called pad, click on it. I use here symmetrically to plane, or symmetric to plane, and the length, I press this fx thing, and aaa dot t1. T, I've used it, of course, the German word Tiefe. Don't care about it, you will use other characters for your parameters. And now I have this thing, and the wings, they are put on the left and the right side, and they are also symmetric and have a little part here. You will see it. So I create a new drawing. This drawing, it must be put from this side here and on the mid of this. So how to create it? I need to create from this side. One moment. It's from this side here. So I create a new drawing. But first of all, I want to be here in the mid. So I first end this function and have a look at it. So we have created this symmetrically, so we can start by using the normal plane. So I create a new a sketch. Now I say, okay, I want to use this plane here, it's the XZ plane, and press OK. Now I'm looking on top of it. I have four circles. One, two, one, and two. And I can click on this two here and give them a dimension. But before doing so, I type it in here. But we can look in the sketch to see what sizes make sense. So this is about 10 millimeters, and this smaller and is smaller. So we have a diameter 1, a it's the large one, give it 2, diameter 2, give it 8, and we have a size here, so I type in here, we have L1 already used, so I name it L2, and this size is not 50, it must be 70, or more than 70, so give it 80. Okay, we close the sketch and use this function here again. Now we change this row to the 8, and I have this parameters also inside to be used. Close this, open the sketch again. So first of all, I select these two midpoints and click on this line and make it symmetric. And now I can dimension this the two points by using this function, and I type here AAA.L2, the 80. I now can select these both circles and use the constraint diameter, and here I use AAA.D1, and these two I selected and give them also a diameter, AAA.D2. You see, these circles here are dimensioned, and this here get a equal sign, so they are dependent on this size. So now I create some lines here. I can create a rectangle going from there to there. This is also symmetric, these two. When I click here, I see now through the 3D piece, and I can select the midpoint and use the symmetric constraint again. Now it's symmetric. This size here, it's the parameter T1, so I use it fx and AAA.T1. And the size of this, it is, I can use this parameter here, the 80 millimeters. So I dimension this and click here AAA.L2. Now I have here these two lines. I've selected them both and press now this icon here, toggle construction geometry. Then they get blue and they are not used. Now I can change here what is visible from these things. I go to this function here and I do it another way. I have here a function, it is called split edge, and I want to split the edge here and there. So I click here and I click there, and now I can move these points to this line here. This I do with this constraint here. Now it sits on this thing I make this here too. Now I can select these two here, delete them, but that's not good. I make them blue. Now I can delete this thing there, where I use this function here and press here, and ready. This must be done on this side too, so go to this function, this, then select it, select this, and move onto the circle, this, and to the circle. Now these two get blue, so they are not used, and delete this thing there with this function, and we are ready on this side too. Okay, now when I press this again here, you see what's happening with this function. Now I see the thing is here, and I need a size for this thickness too, so I name it T2. And T1 was 3 millimeter, makes this 5. And now I close the sketch and use this alias manager again. Put this here to 8. And okay. And now T2 is also yellow and usable. So close this, create. Look at the sketch. I did not have to go into the sketch. I now use the function pad again with the selected sketch. And here is the length. I click on this FX circle and type in AAA.T2. And OK. Now I tell it to be symmetric to plane, so it is in the middle, and press OK. And we are ready with this piece. And now you can change the parameters here. Okay, this shot should be 72 millimeters or 70. Or 60, it's then very near, so you can do 65. Okay, and the height is not the 35, it's only 20 millimeters. You can create many different versions of this piece by just changing the parameters in this table. Okay, that's all for this video. If you like such videos, so please follow me by clicking on the icon. And that's all for today for this video. Have a nice day, and many thanks that you have watched this video. Bye.